Hello viewers, my name is Apostle Helen Rudokeno, coming to you on the waves of Majesty Christian Television Network, your channel of choice. This evening we are bringing to you something you will like. So I will advise that you sit back and take maybe a glass of juice or water with lemon and sit and listen to, relax and listen to what we have to bring to you. It will help you, it will encourage you, and it will empower you to begin to have or desire to have a better, healthy lifestyle. So our topic this evening is on having a healthy lifestyle on a practical perspective. So we have professionals who are going to assist us talk on this issue and show us a practical way of having a healthy lifestyle. Because, you know, I'm so tired of these professionals. They will come, they will say, you do this, you do this, you do this, and then it's like too much of theory. So we have this, we have them today on the show to at least help us have a practical perspective of this whole thing. So in this show today, we will be having, or we are having, by my left side, we have a professional who is also a nutritionist, and you know what, he's also a body trainer, a personal trainer. So as I'm going to introduce him, just get ready to get your own personal trainer. He's no other person but Mr. Alfred Asante, who have been a trainer and a nutritionist here in Amsterdam for almost 10 years.
10 years already.
10 years, yeah, Asante.
Yes.
Welcome to Majesty TV.
Yes, thank you for inviting me.
Yeah, so yes. Those of them who are watching you, they should know that you are Mr. Alfred Asante.
Yes. Yeah.
Wow, awesome. So tell us a little bit about what you do.
I'm a personal trainer, as you said, for 10 years now,
yeah,
in Amsterdam,
yeah,
where I'm living, and most of the time I'm in the studio.
Yeah.
And also I have some clients that go to their house, the yeah. place for mm-hmm. training, also outside. And the most clients, most of all is for training for the health.
Yeah.
Just for the health, and also to lose weight.
Mm-hmm.
Also
to live healthy.
Yeah, live healthy.
Wow.
That's the most important. Yeah.
So I was so. Just saying some few minutes ago, how come that all of you are always so trendy? what's the secret about it?
Yeah, it's the secret. Yeah, there's no secret. I think that's all about the food and good lifestyle.
Oh, wow.
Most of the lifestyle and the balance. The balance of the lifestyle.
So you are, yes. You can look into the camera, yeah, and tell all our viewers right now that all these nutritionists, because all of you have that kind of figure. I call it, you know, figure 11, 1-1. No front, no back. It's so exciting to have you, Mr. Alfred.
Yes.
Thank you for being with us.
Yes.
Well, we also have, at the other extreme, someone that we have come to love. As a matter of fact, you know, Mr. Frank Wijndenbosch has been a theater maker and is still a theater maker. Man, the last time I saw you and you were wearing those girlish things and green, I was so surprised, you know. Please, ladies and gentlemen, help me receive Mr. Frank Wijndenbosch.
Hello.
Welcome, please, to Majesty TV.
Hello.
Yes.
Hello.
So you were weighing actually 186 kilos before, and now you become a bit trendy.
I'm now 100 kilo.
Really?
Yeah. So I lost about 89 kilos, something like that, because I was in 2010 I start, and then I had my first operation. But you asked me about the theater, because I thought it was important to tell people the way I was living,
yeah,
and the way I'm living now.
Okay.
And I made a theater play about it called Kophunger, because Kophunger is the hunger is always in your head.
Yeah,
and
Kophunger.
Even if you're that skinny, like this man and this trained body, you still can have the hunger in your head.
Okay.
And
how?
Well, because it doesn't have anything. Food have less to do with your stomach. They have to do with your head. Yeah. Because first, when you see the cookie, it's your eyes. You know, you see that, and then you want. And we were talking about it. A lot of people can. I could not, and I'm still. Mm-hmm. Every day is a struggle for me because. But I know my body, and I know mm-hmm. to say, listen, Frank, those cookies you cannot have because of all the things that happened to you. So you have to take a banana. And I don't want to take a banana, but I'm taking the banana. Hmm. You know, that's because my mind doesn't work for a banana. My mind works for a cookie.
Yeah.
Well, you have just heard the tips because more is just coming. Should you want to call in, please feel free to give us a call on 020-3374-160. I repeat, 020-3374-160. And then you can join us in this discussion. These professionals are here to help us regain or have understanding to healthy lifestyle. Mm-hmm. Now, tell us, recently we've just begun to hear that Amsterdam, as one of the municipalities in the Netherlands, has become overpledged. They are so plagued with the overweight and obesity.
Yeah.
So, what do you think you, the nutritionist,
mm-hmm.
could have contributed to this plague that is now ravaging the lives of many in the Amsterdam city?
Yes, the obese is, I think they have started from at home.
Uh-huh.
Yes, from their parents and also to teach also how, mm-hmm. What kind of products is good to eat
yeah.
or not.
Yeah.
That's all have to start. So you have to go back from why did they start
okay.
The obese.
Yeah.
And so it's so I have a lot of things just not. You have
in
to go
order.
Back in order. Yeah.
So, but why is it? Why is it that they have the highest level of people who are obese and people who are overweight? In Amsterdam, why? Meanwhile, Amsterdam is.
I think there's. I think it's not only in Amsterdam, but it's about the most European country, and also of course in the States.
Mm-hmm.
There's a lot about all the processed food. There's a lot of E numbers, that yeah. kind of things, and so we have to start to eat. Real food, yes, or to make your own food,
mm-hmm.
Not all to put all the additional on it, and that's all started with it.
Really?
Yes, because you know, as African people, we always put more salt and all the thing extra for, but we don't need it so much.
Really?
Yes.
And maybe we have to stop talk about. Especially what they called autochtone. Let's talk about, because most of the studies are done with allochtone people, and we are allochtone. So let's talk mm-hmm. about them, because when you say that Amsterdam, when you look at the what you call that
mm-hmm.
the schedules, mm-hmm. it's all Moroccan children, Suriname children, mm-hmm. African children, mm-hmm. especially here in the Belmer or mm-hmm. in West. So we have to. It's more. We have to talk a lot more about that. I'm sorry, I care about my people,
yeah.
you know?
Yeah.
And I, because we are in the back bench.
Mm-hmm.
So we have to, that's why he is here, you are here, we're doing that for our people.
Okay, true. Yes.
Exactly. You know, let's do it for our people, and mm-hmm. let's talk about how we can prevent things, because it have also to do a lot with culture.
Mm.
Yes, yes, true. Because I remember a few years ago I was invited by a Suriname. He was writing a book about the Suriname people there in Holland. There, because they want to lose weight, but it was always difficult because
mm-hmm.
The way of eating Suriname is different than here.
Mm-hmm.
Yeah.
But they like the food also to eat. They
yeah.
like it.
Yeah.
The same as the African like the food to eat.
Yeah.
So how can we do something with the food we like to eat, mm-hmm. but still we can lose weight or we can stay healthy.
Yeah,
and that's the most because as a nutrition, we have to be honest also about that. Yes. We still buy the banana, we buy the tire blood, we buy the antrua, but it's all planted in cousin. How you call it?
It's
most of the vegetables didn't touch the food. And you know,
hey, tell me, speak out. They didn't touch where.
He
didn't
touch the ground. He knows better than I do.
I mean, that's why the
tomato.
To biological foods. I mean, when you, for example, when you go to Africa, you eat your vegetables. It tastes totally different than here.
Yeah, it's true.
It's totally different.
Yeah.
If you buy a chicken in Holland, in Africa or Suriname, in your country, it's totally different.
Yeah.
It's all about the biological, the whole process.
Yeah. Yeah.
And there's a lot of salt in all this vegetables and all this stuff because it's processed. It's not on the. That's why when you're in Africa and you buy some vegetables, you just have to put a little bit of oil and the vegetables are totally soft. Do it the same with the vegetables here. You have to cook and cook and cook and before they're soft. Especially this thing called tire blood. I don't know if you know tire blood.
Mm-hmm.
Yeah. You know, normally it's one of the most healthiest food. But here it's so hard that you have to do it with a stamper to make it soft, like an or you can like spinazzi.
Yeah.
Because it's all processed food. Also, did you see the reportage about the tomatoes?
No.
Holland is the biggest producer from tomato, but it's all planted in the air with there is no sun, there is no, and it's good that we know all this stuff.
Hey, tell me. But what I would like us to know, because you've not still answered my question, why is it that Amsterdam is the highest plagued with this obesity and with not having a healthy lifestyle and overweight? Why is Amsterdam city the most plagued above the rest of the municipalities? Is it only in Amsterdam that we have the migrant community or what?
It have to do with that, but it have also to do with money. It have to do with
money
with the family structure. It have to do with the family structure.
Mm-hmm.
In the Suriname culture, it's normal that you don't have a father. There is also a mother, and the mother works two jobs. You know, she doesn't have time to. Of course, I don't know how it's in the African culture, but in other cultures, I don't know about the Suriname. So most of the time, you hear the women, they say they don't have time to go and look. And we have all this idea, and he knows this better.
Yeah, that it's healthy true. Food it's is true. Expensive. It's true what he's saying about time. So we need to plan. Plan as you work a full-time job, is you come home late.
Yeah,
it's too late. So that and your body wants some food. You know, it needs food. You want to eat. You come home. You tire. You want to eat. So the first thing you think is, okay, what we have? Or you go to the appetite or go to the shop.
Yeah.
The first thing you see are all bad foods in the beginning. You know, when you want to buy your food, you know, the good food is all in the back. You have to search where you can find it.
And we don't like to bend.
Yes.
We don't like to bend.
I'm so shocked about what you're saying, because there was this girl, sorry to cut you in, there was this health seminar that Gigi did, recently did, and then somebody was doing an analysis of all the shops.
Yeah.
And then how, he said the bad food are always at the beginning.
Yes. Yeah.
That's where you see all of the sweet and candy things, and then they put them on the levels
the
whereby
cheap, when and children the are coming. Always down.
And the cheapest there. Yeah. The and also and also very easy, because people want to think easy. Yeah. Easy way to finish everything. That's why it's the best for me. The tip is the best for the weekend. Buy your good stuffs and plan. Make a planning for the whole week. If you are busy lifestyle, plan for the whole week, and you know, okay, you make different boxes for vegetables, everything every day what you're gonna eat.
Yeah.
So you know you are eating very healthy, and so. You come home late and then you don't know what to eat, then you have to make food. So you are too tired.
Really?
So but maybe it's good for him to come back another time.
Yeah.
Because what we are a lot missing is nutritionists are telling us what is in the food.
Yeah.
Mm-hmm.
You know, yeah. What is, and we all know about five sugar clown that it's mm-hmm. too much, but we always, in Suriname, we always say you have to eat aubergine because it has got a lot of iron, but I have no idea how much iron
how
is,
you have, yeah,
and how much, sure. and what I have to eat. Cassava also, you know, me with my condition,
yeah.
they advise me not to eat cassava.
Yeah.
You see?
When you are on a diet, they advise you to eat cassava. You know, so there are so many, and it's when a mother has about five children and no husband, and then she have to think about, she's busy thinking, what does five children going to wear the next day to school?
Yeah. Mm-hmm.
She's not busy with, cassava, how much cassava do they have to eat?
Yeah. It's true.
Yeah, yeah.
You know, so it's good to...
So are you saying that people in Amsterdam, they are eating more of these cassavas, that's why they don't have healthy lifestyle?
No.
Yes, any one of you, yes.
But I think also your question, where the point where you were, I think it's more also it's also most about the money. Yeah,
the money.
Because, yes, for if you have the money, you buy good stuff to eat.
Really? Yeah.
Yes.
So
and most people, they are obese.
Yeah.
Most obese, they are don't eat healthy because they're all the unhealthy food.
Yeah, speaking
Very cheap.
Yeah.
Yeah, cheap to buy.
Oh.
The supermarket is closer than the reform shop. You have to say that the supermarket, there is everywhere. I don't know if you can make an advertisement, so I will not call the supermarket's name.
Yeah.
But there are everywhere. To find the reform shop, it's difficult. So it's easy to buy all the stuff. And that's what he said also. Because it's a trap, it's a strategy to make you buy the cheap food.
Yeah, yeah.
I mean, why do you think they make money, the supermarket? They don't care about you.
Of course, the government is concerned. That's why they say, okay, it's difficult for the government to control it. But also they say the five disc or the five disc. That means you try to eat a little bit of this, a little bit of that, a little bit of that.
Yeah.
So carbs and protein and good fat.
Yeah.
And,
So to balance.
Yes.
Yeah.
Yes. Yeah. Yeah. If you don't do that and you eat only every week the same, you eat every week, every three or four times in the week cassava, that's not good.
rice.
That's the rice. Yeah. You know, that's I think the most problem. Also, we eat most of time the same.
Yeah.
That means your body don't get all the nutrients your body need.
Yeah, because something like we in our culture, we don't know this thing called wheat loaf.
No,
many spinach, all this stuff. We don't eat. So I think if you want to change things, you have to start at the beginning and you have to tell people different because people are busy surviving also here in Holland. We take it sometimes too easy. Then, it's a modern country, you can say what you want, you can do what you want, but not everybody is participating in everything.
Yeah.
Because they're busy surviving.
For surviving. Yeah.
Especially older people are busy surviving.
Well, their program, I think, is more for the young people, not really the old, because I think in Netherlands they think the old have finished what they are supposed to do.
Oh, you're never too old.
So can I go now? Because I'm old.
You are not too old. Yeah. But tell me, Mr. Alfred, you are a nutritionist, and what do you think is wrong with the way we live, the way the African migrants live?
Mm-hmm. Yeah. Yeah, of course the food we can put more be more alert about the food, and also the most important, because if you eat all the time healthy, it's not enough. We need also to do some activity in life.
Okay, so
the body needs some activity. Yes.
So in among the African migrants, you
know, they are less people.
Yes,
they are
really
very active. Yeah, there's very less people. They are very active. Most of people, like survive on life. Eh? Just going the whole week, going to work, come home late. Yes. So the excuse is so easy to make.
Yeah.
I don't have time to go to any sport, you know.
Yeah.
So
yeah.
And also come home, you eat very very strong food, you know. Yeah. You know, so then even in the night you don't need that kind of food. You know, it's too late because your body, you don't have need the energy. So.
But that's why it's good to see people like you.
Yeah, exactly.
You know, like an example to see that this man is not driving a fancy car. He's helping you to get healthy. You know, maybe it's a strange comparison, but I mean, you know what I mean. That it's nice. It's good to see examples from your own kind.
Exactly, exactly.
You know, to see because especially I always say to people, when people say, "Oh, you have to exercise," my family, my auntie, my sisters, they go to the shop. So instead of telling them to exercise, tell them, "Listen, when you walk from here to that, then that you exercise also. If you walk it's half a kilometer nearly. So then you have an activity.
Yeah, instead of go by car or something like that, you know, walk, it's also part of the activity.
Go back and
okay.
come.
Okay.
Yes, yes.
Okay. That's a practical one now.
Yes. We need a dool. How you say a dool in English?
Goal.
A goal. We don't go and just walk. We need to know that if I know I'm going to walk to Hanshof to buy some shopping, then I will walk.
Yeah.
Because then I know and many times the sports coaches have to think about things like that.
Mm-hmm.
That the culture is different. We don't jump and say, okay, when I'm sporting in Wester Park and I you know, I can count on one hand dark people, people of color. And you see all those Dutch people are running up and down like crazy. And this part,
it's only them.
But I know for sure you, me, everybody wants to exercise too.
Yeah.
It's the
it's
way.
More the education. Yeah,
it's not to say like we have to, you know, we don't do this or there's too much big people. It's you have to change the culture.
Yes.
Wow.
You have to, because we are not in Africa. We are not in Suriname. We are in Holland, where nobody really cares. You have to care. If you don't love yourself, I cannot curse. How the punches, you're going to love somebody else.
Mm-hmm.
If you don't love yourself first.
Yeah, mm-hmm. It's true.
Love your body.
Okay. So let's hear from Apostle.
Yeah, hello. Just one or two. I was just curious. I agree with you when you said people of color don't really, you know, are not active enough and they don't go out jogging and stuff like that. But what about the food that you're talking about, the non-organic food that they put in front, the cheaper ones?
Mm-hmm.
So is it only the migrant people who know about it because they are saving money, they must do things back home? Or also the native Dutch people are also eating the cheap food.
Everybody's eating that food.
Everybody's eating the cheap food.
There are a lot of Dutch obese.
Yes,
Dutch people or white people. Yeah, obese. They also don't know.
So
how come they don't know? Maybe it's poverty that is making them. I don't think it's that they don't know.
Yeah, some don't know, but it's also, you know, the thing is also it starts with planning, to plan your things. How, for example, when you go to the shop and you have to know what you're gonna get, you write it for yourself. Okay, this is what you're going to buy.
Oh.
When you are just in the shop and
buy
don't know what you're
gonna
buy, you buy a lot of things.
To me all the time.
Yes.
Don't we need an education about the way the shop, the supermarket is arranged and the kinds of foods which people must look out for and maybe try to avoid? Isn't that sort of education necessary for our community? Because if it's like a trap, okay, those who want cheap, they want to pay less for food, okay, we put a cheap one in front, let them take it and go.
Take it and go, yeah.
They don't care what happens to them.
Yeah. Can I say something?
Is it a good idea?
Maybe it doesn't have to start with food. Why do African Suriname people, why do we have to feed the whole town? Why, when the first thing when people come to your house, you cook? Dutch people say, sorry, I don't cook today. I'm sorry.
I don't think we can live like that.
Yeah. Yes. Like the Dutch way. Oh, you have some food? No, I don't cook. I didn't cook today. And when we go to a Suriname, African people, you say, did you cook? And this person said, no. They feel so ashamed. Yeah. You feel so ashamed. And then you run to the supermarket, buy the cheap food, make something, prepare something quickly, and you eat. But sometimes you have to learn to say no. You have to say like, okay, sorry. The money was not enough to cook for all of you and to put big piece of meat and oil and chicken and all this stuff.
Yeah, I think so. All go back to the culture. We are in the culture is normal. So if you get visitors, there should be a food. You know, there should be something. And you are ashamed if you come to me and I have nothing for you. No, it's not possible.
Yes. That's not allowed. But Reverend, can I ask you something?
Yeah,
because you're a Reverend. Yeah. What about, because I learned to not to start food, to throw it away when I'm done, or when I have to throw. But the culture said it's a big sin to throw food away. So what are you
culture?
As a the culture, the Suriname culture said it's a big sin.
You have to eat it all.
Think about all the poor people. So you don't throw it away. Eat it all. You know, so you as a reverend, how can you advise people to if you want to lose weight, you can put that overboard and say, if it's enough, it's enough. Don't keep it, because what we do, we put it in little buckets. You never know, somebody will come, and then the person who comes is yourself, because you're eating it yourself.
Yeah. I think it's all start because we cook a big size. Yeah, we
I've been there. Size. So I know.
We are stressing so much on the food, but stretching so much on the overweight. But the whole topic has to do with a healthy lifestyle. So are we saying that everyone that is overweight is not having a healthy lifestyle?
No.
Is that what we are saying here?
Yeah. No, but it's good to get the bull by the horns, because I've been to a place, the Hehe Day, and there were some Suriname people, and when we talked about obesity, no, don't call me obese, no, I'm full figure.
I'm full,
you know, so
it's part of
I'm
it.
Full, so maybe we have to call, you know, you're the professional, maybe we have to call the by the name,
exactly.
And not go around, you know, and say, oh no, for your culture it's good, the figure, you know, if you're fat, you're fat. You know, if you're overweight, you're overweight. I'm still overweight, you know, so maybe if the first person you have to talk about is yourself.
Yes.
So flowing under a healthy lifestyle means a complete changing of your way.
Change of lifestyle. Keep the balance in lifestyle.
What are the balance?
The balance. For example, what's your favorite dish? I ask you. For example, your favorite dish. You always like to eat.
Yes.
It doesn't mean when you're on diet, you have to throw it that away.
No.
You have to leave it.
Yeah.
Try to keep it, your favorite dish, because you always like to eat, but try to, if you always eat it 3 or 4 times in a week, try to balance that.
Yes.
For once in a week, you eat it, then you eat that. That's part of the balance. Also.
Yeah.
So that means...
My favorite dish really is... I like spaghetti gehakt.
For example, spaghetti gehakt. If you always make it with, oil. The oil and other things, you put extra on it. Try to reduce that. Keep that away. Yeah. Don't put it extra. That's also the balance also.
Don't put extra what now?
Fat or that kind of thing. Leave that. And then just make that your dish, the spaghetti and...
a little bit of tomato sauce helps.
Yeah.
If you make the spaghetti, because there is so much fat already
in the hack.
You just put a little, I buy this tomato, a little bit of tomato sauce, and it's the same. It's the same, you have the same oil, and even then you can take a sieve, and then you put the gehakt in it, and you will see how much fat?
Yes, still he's coming out so much. So much oil comes out from this.
And I know
you know, you lost a lot of weight.
You talked about spaghetti.
Yeah, I love that.
If I tell you you have to eat falcone spaghetti, you say, ugh. Yes, yeah. So because falcone, it's better for your stomach.
Yeah. Okay.
Yes. Yes. The way you say, okay.
Yeah. Yeah. Yeah.
You know, things like that. And, but... because she wants to, Reverend Ruth wanted, so Reverend Ruth is going to make it for herself.
Yes, and what you eat for my, what I'm eating for myself,
am I right?
Need to because yeah, but it costs so much, you know?
No, yeah, exactly, because
it's my health,
it's your health, it costs so much, but still.
It's expensive because you have to make for this one, you have to make for it, but sometimes you have to treat yourself.
Yeah.
You have to be, you have to love yourself first. You know, and then you buy something for yourself, because we think about a lot, because I've learned to be a big egoist.
Yeah.
Wow. Why?
I have to learn because especially when I lost all the weight, I became a different person. So it was difficult for other people to handle me also, you know, and it's easy. The crazy fatty Frank was nice and he was making jokes. So my family, my friends want to have the old Frank back, because then it's easy for them to because they don't have to change. So if you are changing, you have some time to say like, okay, it's my time now, and if because and it's difficult. It's that's why I always say that you need sometimes psychological help. Yeah. How you say that in English?
Yeah, because it's very easy to go back in your old routine. Yeah, you know,
and people want you to go back.
Yeah, people want
because
to.
Because we have to talk about that too. People want don't want you to change also that much.
You know, it's, for example, if you are losing weight and you have your diet. And you go to visit, you know, sometimes you are afraid to go visit someone, because you know there will be a lot of people, the food, different kind of food you don't like. So you are afraid not to go there.
Because you're alone.
Because, you know, you'll be the lonely one. Oh, it's you again. You don't, you're on diet. You don't eat that.
Eat.
So people are sometimes afraid, you know, because.
Really?
And sometimes also people don't want to say to other people they are on diet. You know, they want to keep it by themselves.
I don't, because I don't want to tell it all the time.
Oh, okay.
No, I don't want, because it's difficult, because I cannot eat that much. And
but
difficult.
The one that, because these occasions you're talking about, it's not every time, you know? It's not every time that you go, or maybe for a birthday celebration. Maybe it's only once or wedding anniversary. So then that's where you can get these things to eat, isn't it? So would you, because the one you ate just one day can make you become very big?
No, because it's also, you have to also look at yourself, because the bigger you are, the more people think you want to eat. So when you go to a party, the bigger you... Oh, yes, that's true, because they don't get, skinny people, they don't give much. The bigger you are, oh, you need it. You need an extra portion. So eat it. Because you know you have to. So it's the whole how you call it, your surrounding. And that's what I meant.
You.
Like, you know, you have to be, sometimes you have to be an egoist. And you say like it's you don't do it all the time, but the occasion is all the time, because every time they will give you food to take home. Oh, you need the food. Take it home. You know, so it's the difficult for me many times is that I'm alone. You are when you are doing changes with your body and your life.
At what point did you see the need to have a healthy lifestyle?
The doctor said to me that I'm morbid obesitas. When I was in the hospital, the doctor said, if you go on like this, that after a year you will be dead. And a lot of people...
Oh.
Yeah, you have to face the reality. Eh? You have to people have to do some changes in life. Yeah.
The bigger you are, the less you check your blood your blood sugar. The less you do your blood pressure, and you never stand on a scale.
No.
The bigger you are, you never stand on a scale. You know, because it's confrontation.
Mm-hmm.
Really?
It's true. Yes, yes, yes. It's confrontation.
So it was until the doctors told you you were going to die that yes. made you adopt a healthy lifestyle?
And that was even worse because the doctor don't care about that you are a great actor. The doctor is seeing a very sick person, and you have to make the switch that you are a sick person and not an actor who did TV and all this stuff, because the doctors in the hospital don't care. And we have, and that's what our culture is. Sickness is sometimes something about being weak. So we don't want to admit that we are sick, and or that we need help. Mm-hmm. You know, that's also something you have to. Am I right that you need help? You cannot do it alone.
Yeah, you need help from all your family around you. They should know also what you are exactly. doing also,
they should know.
Understand also why you're doing also. So it helps for occasional also. They know okay, you're coming okay, maybe you can bring also your own food or yeah. something.
Yeah.
But they understand yeah. also why and you're doing that.
Can I say something also? Yeah. You have to ask more, because I will tell you this, when you see somebody, you see that the person is 5 kilos bigger than the last time you saw him or her.
Mm-hmm.
And you will always say, did you get a little bit bigger? And they say, no, my clothes are a little mm-hmm. bit tight because I washed them and they're too tight. And what we
do, living in denial.
And we leave it. No, we are living also in denial because yeah. we are leaving it like that.
Yeah.
But you know that this person gained about 5 or 10 kilos, but we don't say it to them because it's family, it's your child, we are close to them, so we leave them. But there is also a way to talk with them, not to say you are fat, but to say like, listen, I'm going to walk tomorrow to the Belmont. Do you want to come and walk with me? And then it's a different approach than to say like, yeah. my Lord, look at your clothes.
Start to do something. yeah, it's a good one. Yeah.
Oh, well. Because somebody who is out there listening to this broadcast, we are really having one-on-one with these professionals discussing practical perspective of a healthy lifestyle, you know, assisted by professionals. So we want to know how to really have a healthy lifestyle in a practical way, because some people go about saying they cannot do it because it's too theoretical.
I know.
Uh-huh. Yeah. So you have to tell us exactly step by step how you lost weight. And to you, Mr. Alfred Asante, did you purpose in your heart probably to just be what do you call it? A trainer? A body trainer?
But yeah, it's fitness, yeah.
Yeah, fitness trainer. So did you purpose in your heart? That's what you just love to want to do?
Yes, you know what it is? I love to be active. And I love to do sports. That's, I think, the most, very important. If you liked to do some do sports, it doesn't matter what kind of sport, but you like to be active, and that is good. So people that don't, like, it's not only you have to go fitness, but try to do something. You know, it can be a badminton, or it can be just a walk to a supermarket, or but be active.
Yeah.
Yes. And not everybody like to go to the fitness, and you see, understand. But, yeah.
So when you get somebody like Frank before, and then
now also,
what are the practical perspective you to handle him? Can you just tell us?
The most important is about him. We have to talk. We have to see. Okay, how is possible to gain weight so many weights, and then we have to go back. Okay, what was the problem? It can be not only by food. It can be in the mind things, it can be a problem. It can have a problem.
Emotional.
Yeah. Some people are emotional eater. That can be a stress eater. So that can be. So if you know, you talk about that, you know that's the main things. Then you have to do something about that.
Yeah.
Or if you don't do that, we can do some training. We can go on diet. We lose weight, but you go back again.
It's just physical. Yes. You need mental change also.
Yes. That's the most important thing.
Yeah. And you have to learn. Yeah. You start saying that you have to plan.
Yeah.
I still plan my food every day. If I don't plan, well, because I cannot eat that much so because of the operation, but I have to plan my food. Mm-hmm. I have to know, especially with my stomach, I have to know what I can eat and what I cannot eat. But that doesn't mean that it's still emotional, very difficult for me. And it's for a lot of people, because we have this thing that when you're happy, you want to eat. Mm. But when you're sad, you also want to eat.
Yeah.
You know? So when you win some money at the lottery,
the celebration. First thing,
oh my Lord, what am I going to eat? Yes. When somebody died, it's the same thing. Oh, let's cook.
Yeah.
You know? So you have to... Food, you have to put food in a...
Yeah, the food is not the first thing. It's, the thing is we have to feed our body because your body needs something.
Yeah.
Only the good products your body needs, we have to feed. We have to give the body.
Yeah.
Not just like, it's food, just eat and that's all. But and also, what you were saying also about in your mind, it's also very important for if you are eating, if you eat something, try to take the time or first start with a small bowl.
Okay.
If before you have a big bowl, go for a small one.
Mm-hmm.
Yeah.
Okay.
And then after eating, take a break, 15 minutes, you know, because your body needs at least 15 minutes, you know, to think or to say, okay, I'm full or not. But some people eat very fast.
Yeah.
You know, if you eat it very fast and then you eat more. So take more break between your having dinner.
Oh,
Take break. That means you don't rush the food.
You don't rush the food. And also very important to just sit down with the family on the table, not put the TV on, the TV off, sit down, concentrate on the food, us together and eat. Relax, not stressing to eat. When you are stressed,
but
you eat a lot.
But that is really different from how we think in Africa.
That's what I wanted to say.
When you want to eat, you put on the television.
Yeah.
Then sit in front
just
of the
eating.
Television.
Yeah. You know, your mind is
leave your dining table.
Yeah.
Yeah.
Carry your food in your little tray, and then you begin to eat. But don't you think that they are more relaxed when they sit that way than when
you eat more? That is better to keep your dining table this the place you eat.
Yeah.
When you finish, you stand up. This is the place you eat. And on the couch, you sit.
Yeah.
After eat, you relax.
And
but when you relax on the couch, you're just, nice TV, nice show. You just keep on eating. you go for the next one.
can I say something?
Yes.
Because you said when we are people in Africa, but we're not in Africa.
Yeah.
So we are not in Africa. And
exactly.
Also... So this is for parents. They have to learn the children not to eat the bread with a hand. But because when you eat bread with a knife and a fork, you slowly eat more. Also grown up. But we used to go and buy a puncher and hop, and the puncher is gone. And then we hop, and the next puncher is gone. But if you sit, you divide the puncher in two. You spread it open. You put one piece of cheese here.
It tastes more
and
time.
You take... more time to do. So that's why I'm still in going about the culture.
We're
not in Africa. We're not in Suriname.
We're
change the mind.
Yes. And that's what you said. Because eat at a table. Why are you buying a table?
Yeah.
Just and put all these nice things and nobody eats at the table.
Wow. This is nice. Something else. But in your practice as a nutritionist, have you been seeing African men coming?
No, not yet.
They are not interested in the having the
nutrition,
they can't influence their wives to make the good cook.
Yeah, but it has it's also with money, of course, because
it's also macho.
Men don't go. I have most clients are women.
Yeah.
Yeah. So men are always like, I know how to do it. Okay, I can train also. I know how to do it. Men is more like much.
But in the event of to talk about, because me being a man, is that I'm talking about, always talk about culture, because I love the culture.
Mm-hmm.
The culture is we have to take the man by the hand. You know, women are strong. Women are really, they know what to do, but you have to, you as a personal trainer have to talk to men. So listen, brother, why don't you come? Listen, I'm busy there. Why don't you come? Bring your friends. And you know what? You can wear your long pantalon. You don't have to do a short and all this. We have to prepare people. That is our job. We have to prepare people because it's not easy. I'm also in theater. I always tell people also, you want, you are always Dutch people say, why black people don't come to the theater, da 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 da. Because you are making publicity for white people. And we are, we listen to the radio, we listen to local TV. We don't read flyers. No way. If you, if I give you a flyer on the street, but if I stop you, I said, Reverend, I'm going to make a play, and I'm in the play, and I'm telling you about this, and then 100% sure you will come.
Yes.
And that is what we, that's what we have to change. Also, the Dutch people have to know that if you want people to have a lifestyle, a better lifestyle, you have to change your perspective that it's not, African people don't do the way you do it. Suriname people don't do it the way you do it. They do it different, but they want the same result.
You are really passing information across. Yes. Really, that is how it's supposed to be.
Yes.
They have to, the approach has to be different.
Yes.
But we will arrive
this at the is same a good approach. Yeah. Wow. This is a good approach.
Yes.
Because yes. It's not about calories and about you know, going to an expensive gym. It's about food and talk about culture, about your mental state, and about sometimes to say no, sometimes to be an egoist, you know, and things like that. Because it and you know, food is just 2% about the whole circle.
Yeah.
Yeah.
It's a lot more. It's a lot. It's family. It's family oriented. It's also to be honest, because we have to. In Suriname, we have the saying called "Ala nyam bofu nyang, ma ala taki no bofu taki." Everything you can eat, everything, but you cannot say everything.
Wow! Really?
Yeah, and we have to stop that because sometimes you have to say.
Say something really. Yeah. Okay. Wow! Yeah. So you have just given us one. One aspect, because I'm using Mr. Frank today as my case study. Yes, okay.
Yeah, he said that food is just 2% of the problem, but there's so many other things around it. It would be nice to recap some of the main things that are connected to people getting on a healthy lifestyle. Would you be so kind to maybe recap that part of the discussion?
Yes.
Okay.
Yeah. What are the yes.
About the 2%.
He said the food is only 2% of the problem.
Yes.
Obesity and
diabetes. Yeah.
Or
unhealthy lifestyle.
Yes.
Okay.
Food, so because they have.
What are the other parts?
Yeah.
2% is small. So what are the other main issues?
Apart from food, what are the other issues that come?
Family. If first yourself. Family.
Mine. Yeah.
Friends. Where you live. How you live, your work, your family status, are you are you alone, are you have children, are you one parent family? It has so much to do, and the most important thing is that you make a choice for yourself. And that's what I always say, to be egoist. The egoist is not the right word.
Yeah, you think yourself. Yeah.
Yes,
yeah,
to make a choice that today it's Frank turn.
Yeah, it's
today is Reverend Root's turn. Yes. Today is your turn. Mm-hmm. Not your, but it's my turn.
Okay.
Yeah. Well, it's very difficult for most people to say that I'm looking for myself. I want to do something for myself now, because the whole family, environment, work, and so that makes it more important.
So, in a nutshell, you are saying to those who are listening to us that family contributes to people having an unhealthy lifestyle.
Yeah,
is that what you are saying?
Having an unhealthy lifestyle.
The extended family system. You know, because it's like you must always please them when you want to say no. But you have to please them, and then they make you do the things you don't want to do, like eating.
It's not they make you do it. It's the
culture.
Not even the culture. It's the way the family is built.
Mm.
There is not an individual. Yes, individual. There is less, you know, because you eat together, and your grandmother or your mother say you eat, and then you eat.
Yeah.
There is no discussion of no.
No, but that's when you are young. But when you are grown, they can't force you to eat that way. Please.
Yeah, no,
true,
no, no, no.
But yeah, it's also when you are grow up. Also, for example, you go in some party or community. It's also the same. They keep you eat also.
No, they don't force you because when you are bringing still, the food, you say. No, I don't feel like it is too late and I don't want to eat.
And then
I
look at a few people can do that.
And then I look at her, what's going on with Reverend? Yeah. She say, what's going on with Reverend Ruth? She's not eating?
She's losing weight? Or
did you see? I noticed something strange about Reverend Ruth. What is going on?
They start people worrying about you. What's wrong?
Yes.
You're not eating? But this.
And if you start eating, they say, "Oh, we're wrong. She's okay. She's okay. Look, she's eating. She's healthy. She's eating good."
But the same like I know some people that they are when they are on diet, they go to work, and all the people, all the colleagues are asking, "Why is she eating this? Why?" But the day when she's not eating, or you take the cake, or nobody, it's fine. Yeah. Nobody's complaining. When you take cake or other, you know, fast food things, nobody complains. Yeah. But the day you go to work, you bring salad, or like, everybody say, "Huh, what's wrong? What are you doing?"
Yeah.
Then it's strange. So healthy to live a healthy life, and for the most people, it's strange thing.
It's why? Because you don't want all the time people to talk about you and say like, "What are you doing? Why are you doing this and that and that?" So. It's especially for me, it took a long time, and it still takes every day that people, because sometimes people are also telling me, you know, "Are you getting weight? Are you gaining weight again?" And then I have to explain myself to no, and but in their mind, because I always say when somebody have cancer, everybody feel sorry, but when you are overweight, everybody thinks they can say everything they want to say to you. They don't care. They say, like, you know, when you go to the supermarket, if you are big, you go to the supermarket, there's always people that don't eat that. You cannot eat that. You're too big. But if you lose a leg, nobody will say to you, "Why did you lose your leg?" I mean, and that's also, so you build in some defense mechanism.
Yeah.
When you are big, you make it, so you have a lot of excuses, and excuses will not bring you to the sports hall.
No.
Wow. No. So excuses. Let me ask you, the trainer. How can one really form the habit of having a healthy training?
How come?
How can one develop that habit? Because I've seen some women and also men, anyway, who started, but somehow they will, maybe after two years, they stop and the whole weight comes again.
Yes, yeah. That's
so that. How can one really break from that cycle, you know?
To make it
a healthy lifestyle, you know? Something that can help you, you know? You develop it as a habit, since it is very necessary for a healthy lifestyle.
Yeah. Yeah.
So how can one really develop that?
Yeah, the thing is, you have to first look at yourself. Okay, what do you like? What do you like to do? Do you like to do swimming? Do you like to bicycle or walk? And what kind of sport do you really like? There should be one thing you really like, and try to keep that, you know, that activity to do it. And the thing is also, if, for example, if you start to go to the gym, you know, some people start in the beginning 3 or 4 times in a week. But maybe it's better to do it 1 or 2 times in a week, you know, for just the balance also. And so you keep going. Yes. For you know, the in beginning of the year or New Year resolution, everybody wants to go to the
Continue,
everybody
please.
Wants to go to the gym. And then beginning, they are very fanatic to go. And then after a month, and they stopped. This because sometimes it's because they don't like to go to the gym because of the family, of the friends. They are saying, hey, you have to lose weight or you have to do something about it. But then they start to go to the gym. But so you have to make sure, have to go, what he was saying. You have to go. Okay, I have a goal. Mm-hmm. I want to go. I know I have to do some activities. Good for my health.
Yeah.
Do some diet. It's good for me. So you know why you were doing. You restarted, and that helps you more to keep it going.
Can I say something? Because then you know this I cannot run, but I can walk, and I'm walking a lot because many people think when you have to sport, you have to run.
Yeah,
you don't have to run. No. You can walk.
Yes.
You can. It's even if you're big, it's better to walk with before your knees.
Yes. You big. If you big, you go running. You damage your knee. So it's better to walk very fast. You can walk very faster, or something like that, or keep something in your bag. You know, with some weights. You know, it helps.
Running is not that when
like going to the supermarket with two bag of thank you, it helps. You walk, you walk, you know, carry the things, you know, it's also kind of activity as well. You know. Yeah.
And when you sport,
really? Oh my God, yes.
When I always when I sport, I always see other sporters doing this for me. You know, and I walk. So there's a lot of support because we all think that, oh, people are going to laugh at us because we are big. No, people are very supportive. If you do some sport or you walk, everybody's very supportive.
Yeah,
the people who don't sport are and when they sit with the beer or something and you pass by, they go, oh. You know, because but if you do something, some exercise, people will always support you.
So when how necessary is it for training
to train
how necessary is it towards a healthy lifestyle? How necessary, can you tell us?
It's very important because healthy to live and a healthy lifestyle is it's for cancer, for a lot of diseases, you can.
Because that's what I learned is when you exercise, what happened with your heart goes.
Yeah, tell faster. Us a little bit.
Your heart goes faster, and also it's not only it's good for the heart.
The heart,
the heart, long, you know, system is it's
the stomach works so everything. Food goes better, everything. Yes.
And I don't know if. Your digestive it's also gets better also when you keep active. So some people, that's why also when you don't do any activities and you eat a lot of carbs and you keep bloating also. Like bloating.
Yeah.
But when you activities in your lifestyle,
so
and
that,
then
when you are bloating that way, that means your heart is not.
But everything stays, stays inside because there's no way to burn all the carbs, the calories all the time you're eating.
Yeah.
So you need to burn also. So everything stays inside.
Yeah.
And that's the.
Very unhealthy.
And
it's very unhealthy.
Can I also say something? Because I always thought that I was healthy. When I was 189, 86, I thought it was because I didn't walk. So I didn't have problem with my knees. I didn't have problem. I didn't have arthrosis.
You didn't walk?
Because I didn't walk. So I didn't
feel that. You didn't know. Yeah.
Exactly. But when I lose the weight, when I start, then the arthrosis start coming. Then the pain in my stomach, in my bones start. Because many people, that's why I say they don't go to the doctor, because we think we are healthy. Because you don't walk. You don't do nothing, so you sit in a. So of course you will not notice that you have your heart condition. Your heart is going. How you said it, that there's a lot of fat around your heart that it's beating because you don't move. But also when you see those 600-pound body and you see people when they even walk a little bit, they start breathing heavily and all this stuff. Because that's what I noticed when I start, when I start losing the weight, how sick, not sick, it's difficult to say that, but how unhealthy.
Unhealthy you were living before.
Yes. Yeah,
you feel that you get more energy.
And till now, yeah. I'm struggling. Till now, this shoulder is lower than the other one. This, I have much arthrosis. I have to sport because I have heavy
That's
arthrosis.
That's all happening, I think, when you gain weight and then you start to, your body, you know, you start to walk different also because you're not... Balance is not it's not so good, and also for the why we have to do sports is also it's not only the heart and for healthy for you, but it's also good for the mental.
Yes,
things, you know, because when you do some activity sports, you'll be happy also. You feel the hormone, the lucky, you know, hormones get free, you know, in your body, and
you
also
feel,
you
have can say it. You
feel sexy. You feel sexy. Yeah, yeah. In the morning, you wake up, you stand in front of the mirror, so you look at yourself, you're more comfortable and also self-esteem. And also, the way of thinking, you get positive thinking also because of sports.
Really?
Yeah. So you have a lot of good things.
So you are telling our camera, you are looking into the camera and telling us that those who are a bit... overweight, they feel uncomfortable.
Uncomfortable,
do they?
Yes.
Were you feeling uncomfortable when you were?
A lot, but I would never tell you. You had to beat it out of me, and still I would not tell you, because I was okay. I was sitting in my house. I had my bike, so when I want to go to the supermarket, I'll buy. I only get angry when you start looking in my trolley. What kind? How many Fantas? How many Fernandes I had? How many bread I had?
Wow.
Then I would get angry. But and because then you live also a secret life, because you know, because I don't know if you can always say the same, but you know this: when you're overweight, you don't eat in front of people.
Mm-hmm.
You don't eat in front of people. Because when people say, did you gain weight? No, you see how less I eat. I don't eat at all. Because that's what in Dutch we call it, stiekem eet. How you say that in English?
Yeah, yeah, yeah.
Secret eater.
Secret eater, yeah.
Yeah, because you don't want people to know
that
you...
I have a lot of clients that then you ask them, okay, how's your schedule? How do you eat? Can you make a program? Write everything the whole week, and you see, I don't eat. They say I don't eat a lot. I don't know. I eat this. But how is possible you don't lose weight? What's wrong? You know?
Maybe they are not exercising.
No.
Yeah, but still, if you eat less, that means you eat about 100,000 calories or less.
Mm.
You should lose weight also. But of course, you need in combination.
Yeah.
Of course, with exercise, of course. But the thing is that you don't want to tell the truth. People don't want to tell the truth how much they are eating.
Yes.
Because they are...
That's why it's the worst thing. But these nutritionists or people who exercise tell you you have to write. When I was that big, I hate to write.
Hmm.
Because if I write, then I have to face what I'm eating.
Yes.
But if I don't write, he's telling me, but how come you gone on the scale and you gain a kilo? I really don't know the trainer.
Blame the trainer.
It's
you have to know.
You know that I have pain here, so I could not do this exercise. But if I wrote it down that I eat 5 snitches broad instead of 1, he will say, like, okay, there you have it. So you don't write. That's
you
why
gotta face the reality.
People don't want to write. The bigger you are, the less you write.
So
but it's good.
Yeah.
Very good point,
to
write.
Yes.
Daily, what you eat, everything.
Yeah.
1 cola and 2 cookies, write everything.
Yeah.
And then end of the day, and look at the people and see, did I eat this? Confrontation for yourself.
Really?
That's very good.
Okay. So to have a healthy lifestyle, we have to eat less.
But
we have to eat less?
Mm. Of course, you have to eat less. If you eat less, you lose weight.
Okay, and then we have to do some
activities. Yes,
It's
for it is for 70%, 70-80% is food.
Food.
And less activities, less sport, 20%.
20%.
So when you your food is very good, your diet is very good, and then you win a lot.
Yes.
But can somebody who is already big, and then you begin to eat healthier food, lose weight?
You start to eat, when you start cutting a lot of things, like what I was saying beginning, you like spaghetti, stopped, don't put extra oil on it, and that all the small things, you start, like you have your tea, you don't put extra sugar, you start, all the things, and then it helps a lot.
It's called to eat responsibility, how you say that? Responsibly. Yes. Instead of healthy, because many people see healthy food as
not eating anymore.
It's not lekker. It's not. It's not. Yeah. Good, you know. It's. It's vegetarian. Mm-hmm. But what we forget that when we, I think people in Africa also meat. Here we learn to eat big pieces of meat.
Yeah,
in Africa or Suriname, we eat rice, a lot of vegetables, and somewhere in a corner there's a little piece of chicken leg.
That's true.
So and you stare, and most of the time your family just cut the chicken leg. So it's a little.
You are eating the bones. I don't know. You like.
And here we eat this whole chicken. So I always say to friends, like, you know, vegetarian. We've always been vegetarian. Because we here in Holland, we start learning to eat that you have to have big piece of meat.
Yes.
So if you already go back and think about, because you, what you eat in Africa, you know, and you say, like, okay, I'm going to eat less rice. And the vegetables you can still have, and we eat the same chicken leg that we have in, when you were in Africa. You had the chicken leg, and you had to suck on the chicken leg for hours before you find some little meat. Then you're already there. And maybe it's time to start chewing the bones again, because we don't chew bones anymore.
No, we don't chew bones.
We have a lot of meat.
Not chew bones. You get the marrow of the bone.
Yes, exactly. No, because that's for the dog or for the cat. You know, things like that. Yeah. We used to. It's gone. All this meat. Why does a party have so much meat?
Mm.
So much, and also the food. We had in Suriname. We had één pot. How you call it? One pot gerecht. You know, and you can start with that. Also, you don't.
One pot gerecht means just food for yourself.
No, it means a simple food.
Oh, simple.
A little bit of rice, somewhere in the corner, a little piece of meat, you mix it together, you put some black pepper, some tomatoes, some, and you make one pan gerecht, a little pan for just you. Mm. You don't have to buy an expensive rice cooker to make all this rice, and then all the vegetables, and then and two chicken.
Mm-hmm.
Because you always say that the chickens are for somebody who will come, but the chicken is not for somebody who will come, it's for you. Because you order, the next day you say, oh my God, the chicken is going to spoil. Let me start with the leg. Let me start with the breast. And before you know, this whole chicken is gone.
And then
somebody calls you, oh, I'm coming to visit, so you buy another chicken.
Okay, so one of the practical ways of maintaining this healthy lifestyle will be just
no chicken.
Not only chicken. To curtail the quantity of the food you eat.
Yes.
And then to do some to when you eat as well, to
and go out and walk. And you don't need all that meat.
When you eat, you also go and walk, because we are used to immediately we finish eating. Then we are already dozing and
Like that. Yeah. So the time you eat is very important in the evening. Also.
Yeah.
Not too late. You know, because in the evening we don't need the energy.
Mm-hmm.
We don't need in the daytime. Well, for example, for me, I try to eat if I want to eat my rice or with my chicken and beans. I eat it more in the afternoon. And in the evening, and then sometimes I'm full already. I'm okay, and I eat some salad or vegetables and meat. And it's okay.
And meat.
And meat,
Meat, okay.
Yeah, in the evening because it's light. Light diet, so it's good.
No, because and you said vegetable evening, and the meat.
Yeah.
That's okay.
It's okay. You can eat. Yeah, vegetables.
It depends on how much meat.
Yeah, because, of course, yeah.
Because when you talk about meat, we don't talk about the chicken. We're going back to that whole chicken.
So I'm talking about the chicken is only between 100 and 200 grams of meat for everybody's okay.
That's two pieces of kip carbonara.
Enough. Not
not a kip about. Not two kip about.
You know, the thing is, when you in the vegetables and the meat, there are a lot of protein inside, and we need the protein to
All right, this is so beautiful. Honestly speaking, let me ask the last question before we sign off. Now, you were saying something about organic food, you know?
Organic, yeah.
Right, but you also told us now most of the is it to you or Frank? I don't know which one of you said it, but most of this food or vegetables we are eating, they are not grown in a way to give us that nutrition that we need.
Yes.
Because even recently, there was this journal I was reading and I saw that Holland is now the second producer of food.
Yeah.
The second largest producer of...
Largest.
First of tomatoes. Is
It is too beautiful.
Mm-hmm.
So, and you are saying to us now that these things are not planted... you know where
the
the thing is even
so are they nutritious then? Because if they don't make contact with the soil, why are you then calling it organic? Why do we think they are better than the one that is in the can?
Not all the food are organic.
Yeah, I know that.
We have the organic and the standard food we everybody buys. But
okay.
But tomato is a summer fruit. Why does you have to eat in the winter?
Yes, that's a good point. Yeah.
A cucumber. When you're in Africa and you smell the tomato, you smell the cucumber here. So why are we eating still the same amount of not smelling food? Food who doesn't smell.
Yeah. The thing is,
it's maybe a different program also.
Yeah.
About
you.
Sometimes it's good to use your nose, not only your mouth.
Yeah.
You know.
Yeah, it's true.
It's good. It's good to eat like a seasonal.
Yeah.
You know, every season have the own products comes a lot. You know.
Yeah.
So that's also a good way to be very healthy, to live as a to eat very healthy, because you eat seasonal. In some season you have a witlof, a lot of witlof, and the other season has come mice, a lot of mice, then you can have that. So every pasta
is good for the winter though, because it gives you some energy, but you don't need it in the summer. You don't need all this heavy food.
Wow.
In the summer, you can eat some salad.
True. And you see that in the winter, we have the stamppot. The Dutch dish, stamppot. It's most in the winter.
Bruine bonen.
Bruine bonen met cola.
Yeah. You drink with cola?
No, we always have certain people in our ministry, in our church. Yeah, they will always say Bruine bonen met cola.
Oh, maybe their own.
No, it's Bruine bonen met rice. With rice, with chicken, and salt.
And then cola to drink.
Why cola?
Yeah, that's
the worst thing you can do.
Because Bruine bonen is
it's
very good.
Gas.
Yeah.
Bruine bonen is also bone and protein inside, and so it's okay. But like beans, it's beans.
Yeah, it is.
But I don't know why with combination with cola. But
because when they finish eating, they like drink.
But you don't need cola is one of the worst things to drink.
Gas. A lot of sugar.
The last thing, please, people, read when it's cheap, read the label, because then you will see how many salt and sugar is. And the more sugar, you know, please help me with this.
Yeah. The more sugar stays in your life, in your body.
Mm.
And we don't need a lot of sugar.
Yeah.
The supper, you see, 50 gram sugar, and you know, it's a lot. It's a lot of sugar.
Wow.
And then you eat, then you better can take the homemade, lemon, you squeeze it, you put one spoon of sugar, you stir it, and you drink it. It's not that healthy, but it's better than to take a sup, because when you make a sine supper, one glass, how many honestly do you need to make one glass of sine supper?
A lot.
And how many fruits do you need one day?
We need at least two fruits a day, but in a cup of apple juice, the fabric, they will not put all of fruits in the can for you. No, just a little,
a little. So
and the whole, all sugar and all
lot
the
of sugar. Jesus. Yes. So it's better to make it by yourself, like buy your fruit and then do some juice.
Yeah.
Then get some fresh things.
Mm. And stop. So. I'm not going to say, but I'm saying stop buying this stupid thing called iced tea, because everywhere when we were in Suriname and Africa, we used to make our from the old tea.
Yeah.
Your mother used to squeeze a little bit of lemon, a little bit of sugar. That is the same thing, and it's less processed. Just make yourself some iced tea. Buy some mint. Everywhere you can buy mint, put some mint with some cold water, and if it's difficult for you, take a little bit of squeeze, because sometimes we will just want to taste a little bit of sweet.
Yeah.
A little bit of squeeze of honey, and that's it.
Yeah.
You don't need 4 spoons of sugar.
Wow.
But that's also making time, also being, I'm saying again, if you don't love yourself, how the punches, somebody else is going to love you.
Yeah. So the thing is also you have the biological, you can buy organic foods, but we have all the foods now, what we have talked about, tomatoes, and still you have to make choices, and even there is not the good one, but still it's better to eat tomatoes than buy a canned tomatoes, to drink something like that.
Yeah.
So because it's they are some gradients, different, because it's better to have fresh juice to make it for yourself than buy it, the one that supermarket, they already fill it in a can, because all the vitamins is gone. It's gone.
I think when they finish with it, because now people are discovering that these things have not helped them. I think when they have maybe lost their market here, probably they will begin to rush them to Africa. Because I noticed that when we go on vacation in Africa, people, they derive pleasure in telling you, give me some juice, because it's like, that's what it's only before, it's give me cola, give me Fanta, okay?
Give me water.
Not water. When somebody comes to you, they say, give me, buy me cola, buy me Fanta,
Fanta.
But now, it's buy me juice.
Yeah.
Okay.
The packet juice.
People are getting, they get used to, they think about the sugar.
I'm trying to say is that because, these packet drinks were not before in Africa.
Okay.
So right now, it's like it has migrated to that side.
What you mean is that there is the woman on the corner who used to sell the sour water, she's gone.
Yeah.
Now you have the juice.
Yeah.
The very sweet, imported from America.
Exactly, that's what I mean.
And
when they are drinking it, they think it is so good because they will just carry a whole packet for themselves and then put it by the side of their drink.
But can we use some sort of end on a positive note also that you can also spoil yourself sometimes. You don't have to live like a monk, because sometimes, but when you were a child, you were drinking some refreshment, but there was when somebody had a birthday, or you were eating big food when somebody had a birthday. But not every day you were drinking Coca-Cola or Fernandez.
Yeah.
So sometimes you can treat yourself with a glass of Fanta or a glass of.
But that's the balance we're talking about. So not all the time. Not every day, but
not when you're tired or instead of drinking the water, you take the Coca-Cola.
For example, if you are drinking every day one bottle of cola, but try to reduce it to a half.
Yeah.
Try to do it once in 2 days or something like that. So that helps a lot. Helps you.
And you start with a nice thing. You said sometimes you take a glass of juice or sometimes you take a glass of water.
Yes.
No, you take a half glass of juice
and you
mix it with a lot of water and you have the same taste. Because there is so much sugar in such a little bit of apples. I cannot make advertisement.
Yeah.
And put some water and it tastes the same. It tastes like the juice you squeeze out.
Mm-hmm.
Oh, really?
Yeah.
And if you put a little bit of ice also, because we love cold drinks.
Yeah.
There you go.
Yeah.
Okay. That's it.
Okay.
So thank you so much. And those of you who have listened to us, remember, this broadcast has been on the practical perspective of a healthy lifestyle with a view to our professionals explaining to us the best way to have a good, practical, or healthy lifestyle. So I think that they have really tried their best. And do your best as well to cope with these whole principles. So don't just stay there and think because you are from, this is my culture, this is not my culture, so I will just live the way I am and just be myself. In the process of trying to live the way you want to live and then maintain your culture, even though it's not so healthy, remember, it may cost life. So the government or the municipality, city council, Amsterdam, they are all busy making publicity so that people can have healthy lifestyle. Please be a part of it. If you don't have a trainer, we also have our own Mr. Alfred Asante, who is a body trainer.
Yeah.
You are a coach, and then you are also a nutritionist.
Yeah.
So that means you can design all of these things for your family, and then they can have healthy lifestyle.
Yeah,
so feel free to contact his number. Or contact his website. Can we say your website at least?
Yeah, of course.
And that is Asante.
Yeah, alfredasante.nl.
Yes.
Yeah.
alfredasante.nl. alfredasante.nl. That's a very sweet name.
Yes.
So make sure you just Google him and then see how he can be a blessing to you. As well, we have our own Mr. Frank Wijndenbosch, so who is a theater maker. Frank, and also a healthy lifestyle activist. So Frank can also tell you and teach you little principles that can help you stay healthy and stay focused.
And still you still embrace your culture.
Still embrace your culture. So his contact address is also
give my phone number.
Yeah, and not only that, Sixteen.
Seven arts.
They Google it, they will see seven arts, seven and arts, A-R-T-S. So,
and you always can invite both of us to come and talk if you want to. We always can come and talk, and we will be back.
Exactly. Okay. So thank you for watching this program, and keep in touch. Should you want more of this information, just go to majestytv.org or call us on 020-337-4160, and then we can also give you the contact of these our professionals. God richly bless you.
Okay, thank you very much.
It was a pleasure. Thank you so much.
And thank you too.
Keep listening, and bye for now.
Okay.